let's take a look at the Oris Big Crown Pointer Date. I have what is my favorite color iteration in front of the camera today. This is the burgundy dial, 40 millimeters in overall size, with the full stainless steel case and bezel on the leather strap that is naturally cured, vegetable tanned. I think the aesthetics here are excellent. This is one of my favorite brands, guys. One of my favorite brands. I have a lot of respect for Oris for a number of reasons, and I'll get to that through the course of the video. But I think they do a couple things really well. I think they draw on their historic references. They bring retro watches into the modern era. They do a great job. They don't go overboard with, you know, faux tina and things like that. They put a contemporary flair on their historically rich models, which this Big Crown Pointer Date is one of. But they also do some excellent contemporary designs like the Aquis, which I think, oh my goodness, the Aquis, I've owned a few of them. I've reviewed several of them. I think it's about the best. If I had to just pick one diver around $2,000, a Swiss-made daily driver, I think it's got to be the Aquis. I love the originality and the design, the details. Oris, again, is a brand I have respect for. Now, a couple things. This Big Crown Pointer Date was lent in by Oris USA, the brand directly. I'd like to thank them. I am under no obligation to be favorable. I'm not being paid. I don't get a free watch or anything like that. So we're gonna be very transparent about this review. And I will also say that I appreciate them working with me again. My first experience with them was borrowing the new Caliber 400, in which I was pretty negative and harsh. And, you know, the fact that they have continued to work with me, they're sending another watch for me to present and review. I'm still on their press list. That just speaks a lot about them, that they can take criticism and work, you know, professionally. So again, I love Oris. I love a lot of the watches. I've been an owner of many of their watches in recent years, from the Aquis to the Diver 65 to the Big Crown Pointer Date. So let's focus in on this exact version. I'll place the dimensions here on the screen, some of the specifications, the retail price, and let's talk about the history of this model. The original Big Crown Pointer Date debuted decades ago in 1938, so pre-World War II, and let me drop in a picture of it here so we can look at the similarities in the design language and really how little this watch has changed over all of those decades. So you guys can see an enlarged crown at the 3 o'clock position, hence the name Big Crown. We see the pointer date complication, which originally came out in 1915. At least that's when it was patented. And so we have a perfectly balanced dial here where there is no date aperture that kind of breaks up the symmetry. But you can still see the date, which I think is pretty cool. So you see the red tip on the pointer date on the original watch. This new one also carries the red tip, although slightly different at the end portion of the hand. I really like that attention to detail. We have a railroad track on the original, railroad track here on this modern Big Crown Pointer Date. And we also have Arabic markers, not exactly the same font. In the original, they were applied. This one is C1 printed, but I've got to say, I love the font. I love the stylized 6 and 4. I think they're very attractive. Now, the last difference, the original carried the small seconds, and the modern version has a center seconds way of displaying the time here. So let's talk about the way this wears. I like the 40 millimeter size. It's just a hair under 40, a very thin wear on wrist. I know it says 12.1, but a lot of the height is this dramatic sapphire crystal that raises proud of the fluted bezel. So it does feel a little bit thinner than it may look. But I think proportionately, this is a very well laid out, very balanced watch. I like the fact that the bezel is fairly diminutive width-wise. It about matches the width of the Big Crown. So I think that looks strong. And then looking at the dial, we have a very dominant dial. Takes up most of the real estate of the top of the watch if you're looking down, you know, straight on. But it doesn't feel large. It doesn't feel small. It doesn't feel cluttered. I think the length of the cathedral handset, the font, the railroad track, everything about this, and then paired with the excellent burgundy color, which isn't brown, it isn't bright red, it strikes a nice balance between the two. Very vibrant and saturated. I love the color. I think looking at this as a whole, it's easy to see why this is an attractive watch. It's a great seller for this brand. And I feel very fortunate to have it in hand and share it with you guys here on the channel. Now let's talk about the movement. What we have here is the Oris 754 caliber, which essentially is a modified Sellita SW200-1. That's the base movement, which in itself is almost a 2824. There's an extra jewel there. There's a couple small differences, but essentially the movement architecture is the same. We have a 4 hertz beat frequency, 26 jewels, 38 hours of power reserve. And I'll tell you guys, in a week with this watch, I'm averaging plus 5 seconds per day, which is in line with what I have experienced with other Sellita-based calibers from Oris and previous watches that I've reviewed and owned. Now, the specs, I think, say about a 25-second window for acceptable accuracy, but you're going to be getting better than that. They are, you know, over-delivering on an under-promise, if that makes sense. So just on the outside realms of what is acceptable for COSC levels of accuracy, that's what I'm getting here on this Big Crown Pointer Date. Now let's talk about negative elements here. What could be improved about this already very strong offering? I think a couple things. I know some of you will say the water resistance isn't good enough. We have 50 meters here. But keep in mind, this is a pilot watch and we have a screw down crown. So for me, I don't consider that a negative, you know, element. If this was on a bracelet, or if I put this on polished Milanese mesh, I would have no reservations in submerging this watch, cleaning it under the tap, even going swimming with it to a degree, I wouldn't have any issues in doing. So I don't think the water resistance is a big deal, but there are two elements that I think could really enhance this watch. The first one is improved low light luminescence. We have C1 lum, and it's really good in the cathedral handset, the substantial long handset. It lasts, but the printed Arabic markers and the indexes in the railroad track, they do fade very quickly. You know, even after about 10 minutes, they're hard to distinguish, and that is pretty disappointing. Again, it's a pilot piece. It's not a dive watch. We're not looking for crazy luminescence, but I think improved luminescence would be a very welcome aspect to this strong offering. But here's the biggest negative element in my eyes, and this is the anti-reflective treatment or lack thereof. You can get some pretty distracting reflections, especially in natural light, to the degree where my camera even has a hard time focusing in on the watch. It's trying to focus in on the reflections because they are so crisp and defined, almost mirror-like. So I think if this watch carried some potent application of anti-reflective treatment, a few layers on the underside of the crystal, that would just bring this watch to the next level, you know, paired with improved low light luminescence. And I would really be interested in that personally. But on the whole, I'm very high in this watch. I really enjoy the design. And guys, let me know if you agree with me here, but when a specific model within a brand has significant history over decades, you know, this design going back to 1938, this design being a mainstay for Oris, helping them through the height of the quartz crisis in the 1980s, there's something to that that I really appreciate. I don't know, is it silly to place value in the history of a model? Because this watch has some good history within this brand that I respect. So let me know where you guys stand on that. What do you think of the Big Crown Pointer Date? I think, you know, for the going rate for these watches, it's a real strong package. I've often said that Oris, they're not industry leaders in terms of specs. Like when you look at the bezel action or the tolerances from the factory in terms of accuracy for their Sellita-based calibers or the anti-reflective treatment or lack thereof. I mean, there are elements that definitely could be and should be improved, but when you look at the overall package, I can look at something like this, and then I can look at a micro brand that might do better with ARC or might do better with accuracy or something like that. But I have a far greater draw to this model, to the design language, to the history, to the overall package. And I think it's quantifiable. So that concludes the presentation. I want to thank you guys for watching. I want to thank Oris for lending this in. And then I'd also like to let you know that I have a Aquas Hangang edition, the green version, on the way from Saltzman's Watches. And so we're going to be doing a full review on that in the next week or two. For those of you that are like me, you're a fan of Oris, you're looking for more Oris reviews and content, that's on the way. Guys, thanks very much for watching. Let me know if you have any questions, if I can help you in any way. Have a good one, and I'll see you next time.